Philippine Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno stresses the need for regional cooperation between ASEAN member states to weather shared headwinds such as monetary policy tightening and geopolitical tensions. Jokno made that remark at the ASEAN Finance Ministers and Central Bank Governors meeting in Indonesia. He says Southeast Asian nations should strengthen the region's surveillance activities and cooperation on macroeconomic policies and enhance regional financial safety nets. In line with this, Jokno welcomed the ASEAN Infrastructure Fund, which harmonizes regional infrastructure financing in Southeast Asia. He says it has already benefited the Philippines as the AIF has funded Davao's public transport modernization project.
Asian markets rallied on Monday after China's move to cut in half the stamp duty on stock transactions. The Shanghai Composite and the Hong Kong Hang Seng surged at the open before pairing those gains and closing 1% higher each. Japan's Nikkei also climbing 1.7%, its biggest daily rise in 2 months. Some notable stock movements in the region: China Evergrande's return to trade after 17 months was a bust. Its stock plunged nearly 80%, losing around $2 billion in value. The world's most indebted property decided to return to trade after reporting a narrower net loss in the first half of the year at $4.5 billion. Meanwhile, shares of Xpeng in Hong Kong surged 11% following its $744 million deal with Didi. Finally, in Taiwan, major Apple supplier Foxconn bucked the region-wide rally. That's after its billionaire founder, Terry Guo, announced he is making a run for president for a second time. Let's check on European markets. First, they are up on the last trading week of August. Tech stocks are leading the rally, their first climb in three sessions. China-linked sectors such as automakers and industrials are also seeing gains. That's after Beijing's finance ministry announced new measures to boost its capital market. As for Wall Street, futures are pointing to a higher open as well, with investors preparing for several key economic data. That includes preliminary GDP and unemployment numbers. These reports come on the heels of U.S. Federal Reserve Chief Jerome Powell's speech in Wyoming that the Fed is ready to continue raising rates further to fight inflationary pressures.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of 3M after Bloomberg reported the American conglomerate reached a tentative settlement for more than 300,000 lawsuits related to its military earplugs. Shares of 3M are up over 5% before the bell. Also in focus, shares of Chinese EV startup Xpeng, which announced a $744 million deal with ride-hailing company Didi. Xpeng shares in New York are up over 4% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on Bayer's shares after it said an experimental stem cell therapy had shown signs of easing symptoms of Parkinson's disease in an early trial. The drug maker shares are trading slightly up.